FatDag is a Weight Watchers leader in Indianapolis, Indiana. However, the views and opinions expressed during this podcast are his own. They do not represent the views of Weight Watchers. And now, here's your host and wingman, FatDag.
I am your host, FatDag. You're listening to Wise Advice. My weight loss journey failed when I focused on how. It wasn't until I switched my focus to why that I truly transformed myself. Join the show on the web at fatdag.com and follow along on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, all at Wise Advice. Send in your comments, your questions, and your celebrations. I'll include them as part of the show. But before we dive in, remember, when you're out of points, stop eating points. Hey, I'm honored to be your wingman as we walk through this journey together because I believe in you. Well, hello there. Welcome to episode 195 of Wise Advice. Always an honor to be here with you. For those of you checking the show out live on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube, thank you for being part of the live experience of the show. For the rest of you, you certainly can catch the replay or the episode in the Wise Advice app. Look for it in your app store, whether it's the Google Play Store or the Apple App Store, or of course, wherever you can download a podcast. It's truly an honor to be here. Over 2 million downloads. We did that a couple days ago. It just continues to grow, and that's all because you guys reach out and share. You're spreading the word. It's working for you. It's a tool that you found in your toolbox. You like it. You're making it work, and you're letting other people know. That's why we continue to grow. So thank you for being here. I want to open the show with an email from Barb out of California. It's real short. She says, "Hi, Dag. Hey, I had a horrible meeting today. The meeting was full of celebrations. I had a gain despite a week of blue dots. All I could do during this meeting was hold back tears from my disappointment. Please give me some advice as you're a leader. So how do I conquer such feelings? I'm an emotional eater. Thank you, Dag." Barb from California. Well, Barb, I'm going to go out on a limb and say that the fact that you went to the meeting is the part that makes it not horrible. Showing up is 90% of this battle. And of course, I make the number up. It's probably really 91% if you calculate the number. But showing up is a good part of this process. And the meeting room, you know, full of celebrations, that's an incredibly successful group that you're a part of. I certainly understand the disappointment. When we show up, we want to have all the success that we feel that we deserve. And by tracking for a full week of blue dots, that is incredible success. So of course, it's natural and it's right to want the scale to reward those efforts, and you can celebrate with that amazing group that you're a part of. What I want to do is I want to take a moment here and just get you to refocus that. Again, you're sitting in a meeting room with a lot of celebrations, which means you have a group of people who understand how to do this. You have a leader that's leading a group of people well into the way of getting this done. A week of blue dots is certainly celebration worthy. That's where you need to focus your energy. That's where you need to focus your efforts for an entire week. You stayed dialed in, you stayed focused, and you were able to accomplish an incredible goal. Now, it takes 2 to 3 to 4 weeks sometimes for our bodies to completely react to what it is that we're doing. And depending on where you are in your journey, you didn't exactly say in your email, but if you're in the middle of your journey, then that is somewhat common for that to happen. And so what you have to understand is that at this point, quitting does nothing more than get you a new start date. And really what you want to do is just continue with that momentum of the tracking of the blue dots. Now, we also know one of the things about this journey that can be deceiving is that you can put the food in your tracker to get yourself a blue dot, but there is potential and there are possibilities that we enter it in slightly incorrectly, and that could skew the data. So, you know, again, without knowing the entire history here, what I would caution you and ask you to do is look a little deeper into maybe portions and see if your portions are measured and accurately measured properly. Because if you track it as 4 points, but in the reality it's 6 or 7 points, and you do that 3 or 4 times a week, that could put you into an eating in maintenance mode versus eating in weight loss mode. You know, the difference between losing weight and gaining weight is 6 points per day, up to 6 points per day. If you don't believe me, test it. Go into your app and change in the settings and change it from losing weight to maintaining weight. The app will let you give yourself up to 6 points a day, and you get to figure out how many of those you need to maintain your body weight. So what I'm getting at, if you're eating in a weight loss mode, but your tracking is such where you know maybe there's a couple things that aren't getting tracked, maybe you know the portions are a little bit off, and instead of eating a 2-point lunch, you're really eating a 4-point lunch, doing that 3 or 4 times a day, that could mean that you're actually eating in a maintenance mode, but tracking in a weight loss mode. There could be some disparity there. But Barb, really where I want to just go all the way back to is say, you know what, you had a week of blue dots. That is the behavior, that is the mindset that if you carry through that for a much longer period of time, you are going to be someone in that room that's going to be celebrating with the rest of the room. It's inevitable is that if you keep on that path, if you keep tracking and you keep working the plan, you keep getting those blue dots, that is the great focus that we're all after. You clearly did it. You deserve to celebrate in that room as much as everyone else. You know, so go in there, own it. Let your leader know that you did that. I don't know if you hadn't shared that. You know, one of the things that as a leader, and of course, you know, everything I say here is strictly my opinion, but as a leader, I always love it when someone stands up and says, you know what, I did this week. I got a week full of blue dots. Because that is an opportunity for me to celebrate with you as well. It's very important that you find the things that you know you did correctly and celebrate those as we move on. So, Barb, thank you for your email. And I want you to hang on to the rest of the show. And it certainly isn't intentional, but this show is going to be full of celebrations as well, just like your meeting was. But what I want you to take notice is that, again, where you're surrounding yourself with successful people. Isn't that where you always want to be? Welcome to episode 195. So, now, I want to really dive into another couple emails, which I think are absolutely incredible. There's so many successful people on this plan. It's incredible to sit there and say, you know what, hey, so-and-so did it, so-and-so did it, so-and-so did it. And you really have the opportunity to win. And the more you celebrate, the more you hang out with successful people, just like Connie-Jo is, you're going to say, I can do this as well. And so here it is. After 2 years and almost 3 months, this finally happened today. Well, I hit this milestone in my total journey about 6 weeks ago, and to date, I have lost 213 pounds with 74 to go. Today, it became Weight Watcher official as I crossed over the 200-pound loss mark for a total of 203.6 pounds lost. I knew it was going to happen, and I kept it a secret from everyone except for one member of the group that I really wanted her to be at this meeting. Thanks to Cindy and Connie for keeping on their poker face that I could see the genuine look of happiness and surprise on Donna's face. I don't think there was a dry eye in the house, and I got a standing ovation. To say that I'm overwhelmed by shared joy, love, and support that what I've received from this remarkable group of mostly women would be a tremendous understatement. I'm humbled, thankful, and inspired, and encouraged. I will keep going until I am at goal. I will keep going when I'm at goal. Hashtag no finish line nation. Wherever you are in your own weight loss journey, keep going, keep moving. Don't give up on yourself. Persistence, perseverance, and willpower are right there within you. You too are a fighter. And no matter what obstacles you need to overcome, it's possible to do it. Patience, self-love, self-care, and embrace every milestone, every pound lost, every pound gained, every plateau. I've survived unspeakable tragedies in my lifetime, and during this journey, you can do it too. I believe in you, Connie-Jo. 213 pounds lost. Folks, think about that for a second. Think about 213 pounds lost. Do you think during that time period for an entire, 2 years, do you think, and of course we don't all know, right? But do you think for 2.5 years, 213 pounds lost, that every single day was roses? Do you think that maybe along the way there were some hiccups? Maybe along the way there was some not great days in there? And do you think that quitting would have given her a 213-pound weight loss, officially 203.6 on Weight Watchers? I don't think so. I think the only way to get to 213-pound loss is you have to be 100% focused in, dialed in, understanding why you're doing this, waking up often focused on why you're doing it, and then doing your best as things continue to go. Patience, self-love, self-care, all are major, major contributors to this amazing success. The paragraph towards the end that says, wherever you are in your own weight loss journey, keep going, keep moving, don't give up on yourself. Persistence, persevere, and willpower are right there within you. You too are a fighter. No matter what obstacles you need to overcome, it's possible to do it. That sums it up absolutely beautiful. I don't know that I could add much to that. That is just going to give any more inspiration than what that does. But think about it, 213 pounds lost. On day one of this journey, I'm sure many of us, when we embark on this journey, that total number just seems so daunting, and we just want to just say, I'm not sure I can do this. And so we just have to go one by one, step by step, just really, really focused and dialed in. It's incredible what happens when you find a group of people who believe in you. When you get to that meeting room and the standing ovation that comes with a 213-pound weight loss, that tells me that group of people together is dialed in, that group of people together is focused, that group of people is working together all towards a common goal. That is where we find success. That's why you tune into the show. That's why many people join in live. That's why the meeting room is so successful. That's why Connect becomes so successful, is because we want to walk with winners. We want to hang around people that are doing the amazing things that we're trying to do. And as they do it, we believe that we can do it as well. So Connie-Jo ends her email saying that she believes in you. And so I think that comes from a place of love, where she knows now what it takes to get this done. Certainly with a 213-pound weight loss, you have a little bit of credibility in a weight loss journey. And so if she ends her email with "she believes in you," take that to heart. Go prove her right. Go get to goal. Connie-Jo, congratulations on your amazing success. Thanks for tagging me on Facebook. Thanks for shooting in your email so that we can share this amazing celebration as well. At a Camano Island, Camano Island, out of Washington, let's just say, Deborah writes in and says, "Hey, dear Mike, I want to thank you for your service and for the support you give me every day through your podcast. I'm writing this both for myself as a reminder and to share with others a little about my journey. My weight has been an issue ever since high school, which was over 40 years ago. When I was 21, I married a man that was very critical of my appearance. Looking back, I was maybe 10 to 20 pounds overweight. I tried everything to lose weight to make him happy. During that process, I tried Weight Watchers, fasting, and only drinking diet shakes, high-protein diets, even diet medications, including Fen-Phen. During the next 20 years, I continued to lose some weight and then gained more back over and over again, until I was 100 pounds overweight. The Fen-Phen drug helped, and I lost about 30 pounds on it until it was taken off the market for causing damage to the heart. I was so desperate. I remember thinking I would still take the drug if I could just get it. I just wanted to lose that excess weight. I continued to try and please my husband for the next 20 years until I couldn't take it anymore, and I got a divorce. Fast forward 10 years later, my weight was still an issue, and then my life dramatically changed. I went from feeling pretty healthy and strong to being in the hospital in a very critical condition. You see, the drug I took to help me lose the weight ended up damaging my heart severely. One open heart surgery, two other heart surgeries later, my heart was patched back up the best it could be. It's doing much better, but it's left me in AFib, which leaves me feeling tired and weak a lot of the time. I spent about 4 months in a wheelchair during this time and then needed to have both knees replaced the next year due to the excess weight I was carrying around. I was left feeling defeated. I felt old, way too old for my age. I didn't worry about my weight. I just didn't care anymore. I felt like I could never really live a normal life again. I couldn't walk more than a block without resting. On vacations, I would find myself back in a wheelchair at the airport to get to the different gates on time. Then, February 2017, I joined Weight Watchers. I joined not for myself, but to support a friend that asked me to join with her. I am so thankful she did. The timing wasn't right for her then, but apparently the timing is right for me. After a couple weeks, I lost a few pounds and I started to feel a little better. After I lost around 30 pounds, I discovered I could walk a little further. I had hope. I was beginning to realize that my health could improve. Weight Watchers has totally changed my life. I currently have lost 82 pounds, and I feel stronger and healthier than I have in probably 30 years. I can walk over a mile, and I can go to water aerobics several times a week. Your inspiration has encouraged me to go for it all. I don't want to be 10 or 20 pounds overweight, but I want to find that peace inside of me at a normal weight. I'm currently planning my 100-pound weight loss party to celebrate because I know I will get there. I just need to stay focused and remember my why. Thanks again for your devotion to your fellow Weight Watcher members and to the sacrifices you make for us, and thanks for being my wingman, Debra. And Debra on Connect is Beach Gem 60, BEACHGEM 60. Debra, congratulations. 82 pounds lost. That is all you. That is you out there getting it done. That's you being focused on your why. And what a roller coaster of a story you took us through. And I really want to just take a moment to thank you for writing in and sharing such a remarkable journey that you had. And, you know, looking back, the obvious thing in your email is your health is now completely improving, but there was a time when it deteriorated and strictly as a result of us wanting this so badly. You know, every single person I've met who was on this journey, you know, if we had that magic pill, if we had that magic wand, we would all use it if we truly believed that would work. I firmly believe that we have the magic, and the magic is the accountability. The magic is the engagement. The magic is us pulling together with similar people who understand the journey. So, you know, supplements and all those, there's so many other things out there that just aren't exactly the tricks that we need. And the trick we need is for us to just figure out now, eating right, working out more, moving more. That is the goal that we're after. Keep doing that, and you will continue to have amazing success. Now, obviously, you know, you're very, very early on when you tried to lose weight simply to please your husband. Certainly, you know, that was not the recipe for success. And I'm glad to see that you realize that didn't work as well. You have to do this process. You have to go through it for you. There's no other way. And so the story from in your email, going from all the way from giving up to reaching to coming up on reaching goal, is the true story that we want to share. Is that, you know, feeling like you were defeated and didn't really want, just didn't care anymore. That's a feeling that we understand when we get to that point, we are completely broken down. And when you get to that point, it's a long climb up, but every step you take makes the climb more successful. There's a series of small victories that we have to celebrate along the way to get there. You know, being able now to walk a mile, go into water aerobics, the things that you've written down continue to be small victories that will continue to bring a smile to your face, that continue to bring joy to your journey. Every single day you find something new that you can do, those non-scale victories, those are the celebrations that make you want to celebrate even further. I love the fact that you're currently planning a 100-pound weight loss party, but I would say, you know what? Celebrate now. 82 pounds is no joke. You have certainly earned any celebration you want to go plan. Don't wait for 100. Don't worry about the nice round number. Celebrate now the amazing gift that you've given yourself back. That's what I want to do. That I want to celebrate with you now. Because 82 pounds, you absolutely are a rock star. You clearly are dialed in. You clearly are focused. And I truly appreciate you sharing your entire journey with those of us. And, you know, you bring a part to this show that I so often tell folks is that I really just want you to write in because your celebration, your story can help someone else. And your story does just that. Is from all the way from the very beginning to the very end. It's just an amazing story of triumph. It would be so much easier to just give up, but you didn't do that because you're a fighter and you understand what's at stake. That is how you're able to power through. And that's why I'm so proud of you for sharing. Out of Texas, coming up next, Rachel writes in. And she said, "Hey, dear Mike, my name is Rachel. I live in Texas. I just wanted to email you this morning to share my celebration with you. As of my meeting yesterday, I have lost 50.2 pounds. I am so excited and I'm proud of how far that I've come, but I honestly could not do it without you and each of my fellow wingmen being as supportive as you are. I have a huge group of support that I never dreamed possible, and each and every one of you helped me to remain focused on my why, and for that, I am forever grateful. Once again, thanks for all that you do for us and for your service to our country. Sincerely, Rachel, RACHCAN95 on Connect." And Rachel, 50.2 pounds. Congratulations on that. How's it feel? 50.2 pounds. Think about that for a second. 50.2 pounds. Now, everything's bigger in Texas except for you. You're actually down 50.2 pounds. Amazing. I'm sure you feel incredible. It's awesome to see as you write in that you are so excited and proud of how far you come, because that excitement, that pride is the internal feeling that will continue you on this path. You know, I appreciate the shout out. I really do. And, you know, and knowing that the fellow wingmen being as supportive as they are and your huge support group, all of those things helped you to get here. Now, when you say that you honestly could not do it without you, I actually disagree. You certainly could do this alone. I'm absolutely glad that you didn't, but you have the ability to do this all on your own at this point. There were times when you had to make a decision and there was no one there to help you, no one there to guide you. You weren't plugged in 24/7 into the support group. So that's why I say you have the ability to do this on your own. Now, certainly the support group is amazing. I credit that for my success as well. But I want you to understand that without the support group, without the amazing tools that we have, you still can do this. Pam reminds me on Facebook that 50.2 pounds is 5 10-pound bags of potatoes. Put that in your cart, pushed it around the store for a little bit. Understand exactly what you've done by removing 50.2 pounds. So again, continue to use the tools that are available. Continue to stay plugged into the group. Continue to stay plugged into your meeting. But know that you did this. You did this on your own. You did this for you. You can continue to do this. And then once you get to the place where you are truly content, you're truly happy, you've stepped on the scale for the very last time in a weight loss mode, it's at that point you reach back to that support group that you relied on. And you offer the support back and you carry someone else for a little bit of ways until they too get to the point where they believe in themselves as well. So, Rachel, thank you so much for writing in. Really, really appreciate you sharing that. Out of Los Angeles, California, Devon writes in and says, "Dear FatDag, I first wrote to you October 2017 when I celebrated my 1-year Weight Watcher anniversary. I had made a promise to myself that I would write to you as you had been a huge inspiration to me in my journey. At that time, I had lost just over 52 pounds. I made another promise to myself that I would write to you when I reached lifetime. Fast forward to today, I can proudly say that I have achieved lifetime just a few hours ago. I've now lost 83.4 pounds, and I feel absolutely amazing. But this journey certainly wasn't easy. In my meeting today, my leader asked me to share a few things. I wanted to also share them with you in hopes that they would encourage others. You see, I'm a normal person just like everyone else. When I joined Weight Watchers, the heavens didn't open, the angels didn't sing, and I didn't magically figure it all out. I struggled my way to an 83.4 pound weight loss. I gained every fourth or fifth week. But I learned that the magic of this program is in showing up every day and stringing one successful moment after another. The more successes that I strung together, the more successful I was. About halfway through my weight loss, I realized that I actually could do this. It wasn't until then that I truly believed I would be successful and reach my weight loss goal. At that point, I told myself that I wouldn't quit, and if I didn't quit, I couldn't fail. Last week, I was in New Orleans for a work trip. I spent time with a colleague that I hadn't seen in a while. I told him how I had gotten up and gone for a run through the French Quarter that morning and that night before I'd gone out by myself to listen to some live music. He looked at me and said, "Who are you?" He's right. I never would have done this kind of stuff before when I was overweight. Without thinking, I turned to him and I said, "I just got tired of living on the sidelines." As I reflected on that, I realized that this is such a terrific metaphor for what we gain on Weight Watchers. Yes, I'm happy to be fitting in smaller clothes, but I'm also happy at the new life that I have. I'm living and experiencing life in a way that I never, ever have before, and I wasn't even sure if I could. Well, and if I can do it, everyone else can too. Sincerely, Devon. Devon, way to go. 83.4 pounds, lifetime. Isn't that incredible? I love how you made time to make sure that you summarized your entire journey with the "it feels absolutely amazing." You have to tap into the feeling side of this thing. You know, when you start recognizing how you feel, that's where true success starts coming from. Is, you know, certainly we can look good, but when we feel good, everything else falls into place. So congratulations. Absolutely on doing that. For the rest of you listening, I would caution you not to wait until you hit these major milestones to write in. Your story has tremendous value long before you reach lifetime, long before you set a goal and reach it for yourself. Your story has value every step of the way. So I would encourage you not to wait to those milestones to write it in, but certainly as you hit them, continue to write in and share them as well. You know, Devon, I'm glad that you took the time to write in, because it absolutely does encourage everybody else as they hear how the amazing success that you're having. You know, I believe in the same things that you believe, is that I'm a normal person just like everyone else. You know, I work too many jobs. I have a family. I got too much going on. You know, when I joined Weight Watchers, no, the gates didn't open up. Angels didn't sing either. Nothing magic happened. I wasn't given the tools to, I wasn't given the magic wand to success. It wasn't like, boom, just do this and it works. I had to, just like you, figure my way out through this. It's going to be different for everyone, but the piece that is the truth for all of us is that if you don't quit, you can't fail. That is the success. And it's a matter of taking those small victories we talked about earlier and celebrating them. And every time you reach something new, you smile, you celebrate, you share it. You know, you really just go, okay, I did that. I can just do it one more time. It's kind of like running, you know, running a race. Just get to the next light pole. Just get to the next, you know, crack in the sidewalk. Just get to the next whatever. Just keep moving and celebrate. And the more success you have, the more you want to have more success. Success feels good. And don't wait till major milestones to celebrate them. I want you to find something right now that you can celebrate that is successful that maybe you didn't understand before. And that smile, that joy that comes from you saying, hey, you know what? I actually did that. And then you say, and now I want to try this. And I did that as well. By not quitting, you certainly can't fail. It's those small victories along the way that make you get it up. So when your coworker looked at you and said, who are you? I think next time what I want you to answer with is, well, you know what? I'm actually the same person as I was before. I just have different goals. Nothing changed about you, you know, to that drastic where you're a completely different person in a sense. You know, certainly we have some different feelings. We have some different attitudes. We have some different activities that we participate in, but you're still the good dang person that you were all along. You just now have a better insight of the goals that you want and the future that you want for your life. And you're out there getting it done, waking up on a vacation and a work trip and going for a run before the workday starts. That is the fun part of this journey. Continue to reflect on all the amazing stuff that you've done. You know, the fitting into smaller clothes, that is absolutely fun. Be happy. Celebrate the new life that you have. And, you know, the fact that you weren't sure that you could do it, you have to remember that I knew you could do it. I knew early on that you could do it because I just know that about this journey is that it can be done. And so now that you understand that, it's always awesome to see when somebody gets to the point where you're at is when you reach back and say, you know what, if I can do it, everyone else can too. That's why we believe in each other is those of us who walk ahead of us, those of us who chart the course prior to us getting there, they convince us that the journey is worth taking. They convince us that the next step is safe to take. And they believe in us, and we believe in you. And if you want to get this done, focus on why you're doing it. Tap into the feeling of little successes. Celebrate every single step along the way and completely crush your goals. Well, what is it that you're celebrating? Let's share it on the air. Go to fatdag.com. Click on the Wise Advice podcast link to send in your celebrations, your comments, your questions, and I'll work them in as part of the show. You certainly could email in as well at onair@fatdag.com. It takes me about a month or so to get to your emails, and when they do, I kind of work through them, and I put them on the show. I'll let you know usually about the night before or the night of that I'm going to do the show live. But I really want you to email in your celebrations because as you heard through this story tonight, through all these stories, is those stories of celebrations really, really remind the rest of us what we're fighting for, and we're proud of what we're doing. We're proud to get this done. If your journey isn't full of celebrations, write in there as well. Let's continue to talk about it. Let's continue to share it. Get plugged into the Facebook group, the Wise Wingman Facebook group. We're here to help you walk this journey. You can do this. You absolutely can completely change your life. All it takes is being mindful of what you're eating. Move more, get a little more activity, focus on all the positive things you have going on in your life, and you'll get it done. It reminds me quickly of a story that I love to share is that it's kind of like that new car analogy, right? And so, you know, when you first go buy the car, you walk on the lot and this car captures your attention. It's a car you've never seen before in a color that you've never seen before with options that you've never seen before. It you gravitate towards it. You get there and you buy the most amazing, unique, one-of-a-kind car on the planet. You negotiate with the salesman. You drive away. And I'll be darned if you don't pass that same exact car 17 times on your way home. Your brain wasn't ready to see it until you finally started focusing on it. And once you focused on it, it became, you know, part of who you are, and your vision cleared up, and now you're able to see the rest of them. As you celebrate on with your victories, as you start looking for small victories, it's just like that car. It just you celebrate one victory, and then all of a sudden your vision opens up, and you're able to see all of the other victories going on. That's why we share all of this together. Well, that's going to do it for this time. Remember that losing weight and getting healthy has nothing to do with luck. You have to remain disciplined and focused. Set your sights on your goal and go after it. wish you good focus. Thank you for listening to the Wise Advice Podcast. Did you know for as little as $1 a month, you can take the next step as a wingman and support the show? Visit FatDag.com, click on Become a Patron today.